Good morning to everyone, especially all the English football fans out there. Croatian man Andrej Maravich here for What Culture Wrestling. This is your morning news update, and I regret to inform you that WWE are at it again. In a year when the company have held two separate Royal Rumble events and four-hour pay-per-views have become standard, those mad bastards are apparently set to take their obsession with super-serving their audience to the very next level. That's because, according to a new report from barnburner.ca, WWE plan on hosting two separate WrestleMania events every year starting in 2020, which is just... ugh. In WWE's giant ocean of content, WrestleMania is the one event that still feels special, still feels unique, still feels worth building up to, but that may no longer be the case if they start holding it every 6 months. According to the write-up, they'll still be holding the one traditional event in America around about April time, as has become custom, and they'll hold another later in the year, perhaps around October, on foreign soil. So if this does come to fruition, at least the company will be spreading them out a little bit. Can you imagine the horror of enduring two individual WrestleMania shows on a single day? That would be an absolute nightmare, but according to Barnburner sources, the idea will be similar to that used for the Royal Rumble and the Greatest Royal Rumble. So, does that mean we're going to see the greatest WrestleMania somewhere in a stadium in, I don't know, Yemen in 2020? Well, it sure sounds like something the company would do, but it would completely reshape their annual calendar. The company's entire storytelling mechanism is built around working towards one WrestleMania, so if there's two and they plan on taking the second one seriously, they're going to completely need to change the way they tell stories. The absolute worst thing they could do is turn the second WrestleMania into a glorified house show as they did with the Greatest Royal Rumble. That'd be a terrible shame, but that being said, the idea of a pay-per-view on foreign soil does sound pretty sweet, particularly if they come to the UK. But as always, remember that this is only talk at the moment. It's all rumours and conjecture, so remember that before you get yourselves too carried away down in the comments section. Actually, come to think of it, scratch all that. It's more fun when you get worked up and annoyed. So do that. Let us know what you think down below and tell us if this is actually something you want to see. Once you've done that, like, share and subscribe. And once you've done that, head over to whatculture.com/WWE. Check out some great articles by the likes of Jamie Kennedy, Michael Hamflett and Michael Sidgwick. You'll have a great time. I've been Andy and I'll see you later.